came from Ontario. That someone asked me, with who do I train, right? And what the changes I saw in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu in those 50 years that I practice, right? First of all, my BJJ instructors, the only one, was Carson Grace. And in the beginning, the first only 3 weeks, his brother Jose Grace also was my instructor that gave me the self-defense program classes, right? So I learned the whole program in 3 weeks, and after that, I could go to the big dojo to start to train in real Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. But I knew already all the 36 moves of the self-defense that I think something very important everybody should know, right? So if somebody attack you or hold you and you don't get afraid and you can relax and know how to get out of the position. So I, my opinion is very important to know self-defense. That's the reason in these live techniques, I'm gonna put also some self-defense moves, okay? And the continue his question. He asked me about how I saw the changes in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu those 50 years. Everything in life changed, right? So, and for me, what's important in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu are 3 things, right? So, your base and posture in the fight is essential, your hip movement on the ground, and your grip. If you have these 3 elements, you can fight well in Jiu-Jitsu. So, that's my opinion. And the big change that I saw is more about the game, right? So, what happened in the game when I started to train? We used to fight like animal hunting, right? You go to the guy to take him down, pass the guard and submit him. Doesn't matter in which one of the dominant positions, with knee on the belly, side mount, in the mount position, take his back if you turn the back to you. But we are always trying to finish the fight and always avoiding giving space to the opponents and putting pressure, because all the fight in Jiu-Jitsu for the space, right? So if you don't give space when you are on the top, you can control the guy very easy. The guy has to fight to create space. So you can be rest on the top and the guy on the bottom gonna be fighting to create his space. So you have no rest, right? So of course you'll be on the top position. You have the help of the gravity and you can dominate the fights and go for the submissions and make the guy only defend himself. So that's the reason I believe fighting on the top is the easiest way to win the fight. Anyway, we're gonna start here with the first technique. I'm gonna show how it's easy. Zeke, please. I'm gonna hold his arm here just for you guys see. If you try to pull his arm back, see? The person is stronger than you, you can't do that. In Jiu-Jitsu, we always create the leverage to make the technique work better. Now, with a little movement, right? You're gonna step forward and bend his arm. He totally, you see, I lost the grip right away. So again, you try to pull, I'm stronger, he cannot take it off. You're gonna do the leverage now, step over, see if I lost the grip right away. So it's a very simple move to get out from this position, okay? In case he hold me with the cross grip, right? Like that, right? So he's holding my wrist, I also can hold his wrist at the same time, right?
So he has my wrist and I have his wrist. But now I go do the action. So I'm gonna drag him for me, bring my elbow up, and my hand go behind the shoulder to push him down. And very important here, I step over his leg so he cannot turn away. The only position you go here, gonna be to the ground. If, go back there. If I do the movement, right? When I pull, I push him and don't step over his leg. He's gonna walk around and come back straight again and get out. So I have to stop him to do the movement. Okay, so once again, hold my wrist. I'm gonna hold it, step, elbow up, push the shoulder, step in front of the leg. See? Now I have total control of the situation here. So, just to show that anyone can do against bigger opponents, right? I'm gonna hold his wrist and he's gonna do it with me. So I control, he step back, lift his elbow, push my shoulder, and step in front of my leg, I tap with pressure on my arm here. So those are the two techniques we're gonna work for the self-defense today. Every class I'm gonna show different ones. And now I'm gonna just check here with you guys if somebody asks any questions, so we go to techniques.
The only one I seen, I don't know who it was, somebody asked about a single leg takedown, I think it was. But does anybody have any questions they want to ask before Marcus shows any more techniques? Because after the self-defense, he moves on to the techniques that he's going to show for the day. Doesn't look like it. Just the single leg.
Okay. So come here. We're gonna start here with the basic grip to start the fight. So I control the collar in front of the shoulder.
Someone said, how to do a single leg stack pass.
Oh, single leg stack pass.
Okay, single leg stack pass. I don't know exactly what he's talking about.
Tell him to send it to the email.
Second. Any question? Possible, possibly from guard.
Maybe when you stack them and then push the leg over.
Let's do a guard pass doing the.
So, just so you don't mix the things here, I just want to keep you going for this technique I was using here, right? So, we have the grip here. Hold the collar, hold the sleeve, right? But now, if I go to his leg, it's very easy, right? So I go to the leg, I'm gonna step back, he's stronger than me. It's gonna be hard to catch the leg, right? So what I'm gonna do, I have to, the first thing is stop him to move away from me, right? So I'm gonna do a little step inside, one, my arm coming over, two, and now take a look. My hand on the collar, I'm gonna drag him close to me and hold it the dots. Now, if you try to walk away from me, you can do it, see? I put our bodies together in the position here. So now I can squat, incline him, to make you put all the weight on his foot, so impossible he step back, because if he keep it straight, if I go to the leg, he still can step back, right? When I make him put all the weight on his leg, right? Now I can go and he cannot move. I do the grip, bring it up, right? And now I can just circle here. You're gonna fall. And I have the control. When I get to this position, for example, I can go to the wrong knee on the belly and catch his foot here to control him. Now I can go, back. I have the ankle lock. It's a straight ankle lock, right? Legal in all the organizations, right? And he cannot move because the control of the leg, don't let it spin around or use the other leg to try to kick me here, to push me. So I control this leg here, mm-hmm. have the control.
Okay, I think we got, do you want to do that one again? I think we got clarification on the person's.
I can do one more time with this one.
Okay.
Have the grip.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do, just to remind you guys, little step. If I step right here, I don't have good control. So I always try to keep my feet the same distance of my shoulder. I don't close and I don't open too much mm-hmm. to keep a good balance, right? So I'm gonna go, step, drag him, hold the belt, incline him, squat. Hold the pants, lift it up and out. Another thing, when I hold here, soon as I finish the grip, I'm gonna incline him to the opposite side now, because it's easier for me to bring the leg up. If you keep all the weight on the leg, and I try to lift, I can do it. So this manipulation here, make the movement easy to me. So I have the belt, I have the knee, one step back, circling, and I'm gonna fall. I need to go to the belly to stop him, wrap the ankle, hold my collar, and the ankle lock.
Okay. The person.
So now we can try to go to the one they ask about. I didn't understand the question very well.
They want the guard pass. I think that you squeeze your knee when you pass, stack them, and do the choke.
Okay.
If that's not it, that's what you're getting.
Okay, so I mean his guard here. How I said, my posture here in this position, very, very important, okay? So, every time if I lose my posture, I'm gonna bring my neck closer to him, he's gonna attack my neck. So, I'm in a bad spot here. So I have to keep my posture, my neck, away from his hands. He's gonna try to control my collar, right? And control my sleeve, that's the basic grip that they do when somebody goes to your guide. So, I'm gonna work my posture here, how I said, and my grips now. So, people ask me sometimes this, I have to go here, about my grip. Some people like to put the indicator finger between the collars and hold the collar right here. So I don't like this grip too much because I don't believe it is strong enough. So if he hold his collars, right, and he open up, I lost my grip. So he have way more leverage than me. Right? And what's the reason I have the grip on the guy? I have the grip to avoid him pull me down, and if he open the leg, to move the hip away to create space that's gonna complicate me, right? So he's gonna close the leg, I like to use this grip here. Four fingers inside of the collar, right? My knuckles gonna be pressuring his diaphragm right here. He can hold my collar with both hands and try to pull me down. Look here. How uncomfortable is for him. Every time he pull me, I pressure it here. So he don't wanna have this exchange with me because he's in disadvantage here, right? And my second hand, I like to control the knee beside here, right? So most of the moves he wanna do to attack me here, he needed the legs. So if I control one of the legs, I limit his attacks. I kill his attacks in this position. He cannot do the arm lock, he cannot do triangle choke, because I have the control of the leg. Now, close. But now, take a look. I have to open, right? So how am I gonna open this now? I'm gonna put my foot on the ground, the same side I'm holding the collar, right? I'm gonna bring it up, foot on the ground, and pinch my leg, see? So when I pinch my leg here, the leg pop open, see? So now I just go, see? Push the leg down, and I'm right there to pass very easy, to pass the guy. So I hope you guys understand the reason that I did those kind of grips to control the opponent and how he become weak to defend the guard pass. Okay? So if you guys want to know, I'm gonna let Zeke do the move with me to see the difference of size. Doesn't matter.
Got this, Zeke.
He's coming, my God. Close, grip, grip. The hand is on the diaphragm, right here. Because if I pull you down, keep your arm straight, look, pressure here, right? And this muscle here on the diaphragm is what's responsible for my breathing here, right? The guy put too much pressure here to me on the belly, for example, I have a problem to breathe here. So I cannot let the squeezing, right? So from here now, he have the good posture, holding the leg. But now he have a problem. He have to open my leg. My leg is still closed. What he gonna do? Put his right foot on the ground, beside my hip. When he pinch, he put my leg weak, so I open. That's it. See? He still have the control there. Now, he's gonna move his hip forward. Hip, just a hip. Grow and move your hip forward, yeah. And this hand now go behind my leg and push my leg to the ground. And he's right there, inside the mount position. So you see, when you use the leverage, this size difference is not a problem, right? So he's very smaller and lighter than me, but he still can do the technique. So something else you guys ask. Okay, I just wanna repeat this technique because somebody else may ask to do the choke after the technique, right? So I'm gonna finish here and do the choke. Here we go again.
Someone said, can you please show the step around again?
Okay, he's gonna do it again. So.
Okay, so close the leg, hold the collar, hold the sleeve. Yes. I have my grip blocking him. control of the pants right here. All my foot go to the ground. I pinch to open the leg. Okay? So sometimes if I push the leg here, I pass the guy already, right? But they ask me here about the choke to submit him. So when I pinch here, this hand now, I'm gonna put his leg over my shoulder and hold the collar. I have no problem here against triangle because my arm is not inside and I have the control of the other leg, right? So now I put my thumb deep inside the collar, as deep as I can, until my wrist touch the neck. If my wrist have no contact with the neck, my choke is gonna be garbage here, right? So I have to go as deep as I can, make the grip strong. Now, when I drop my knee, I'm gonna drop beside his shoulder, because if I put the knee on the hip line, he have power to push me back. You see, hard for me to come forward here. So if my knee goes forward here, beside the shoulder, I lift the other one, and this hand holding the knee, I'm gonna hold his pants on the back, right here. See? Now I force my elbow to the ground. When I lift the hip, he's gonna attack right away.
Can you show that really quick again? The lifting the hip? Never mind.
I just switch my hand from the pants, from the knee, right? Behind his pants, right in the middle of his body, to keep his hip out of the ground and apply the pressure. His hip is on the ground, I can't apply the pressure. So I need to use the weight of my body and keep him in a very uncomfortable position. So I'm gonna let him do it then and now. Deep side collar, which I need on the floor, the side of the shoulder, and lift the other leg right away. You have to keep his leg beside your neck the whole time. You don't throw, because it's uncomfortable for him. You have to force his knee against his face. That's why people not flexible. Sometimes they tap just with the pressure with them. Yes, knee on the ground, lift the other leg, hold the pants on the back. Now force the knee to his face. See? Choke comes right away.
Norm Hall said knee on belly escape to sweep. Question mark.
Knee on the belly escape. Let's go there. You stand up. Come to this side. Oh. Okay, so take a look here. First, this one, I understand. If I am on the bottom, I should avoid to be flat on the ground, right? Some people in the fights, look, they are in Copacabana, 10. I cannot be like this. These are positions to go 10 at the beach. In the fights, I go to the bottom. I have to turn my body to the side position, always facing the opponent. I never ever turn my back to him, right? So just for you guys to understand, Zeke is this side here. See right here? Come a little closer. Yeah, right? I have to turn to him. If you go to the other side, I do the same thing. Like straight, and I turn it to him. This foot here on the floor, you see, keep my butt out of the ground. And he can put his two hands here on my hip and try to push me. Put your hands here. Try to push me down. He can't. See? My leverage here is very strong, right? And stepping.
Go back there.
When somebody puts the knee on my belly, right? They're gonna apply a lot of pressure here on my stomach, my diaphragm, whatever, right? So if I stay flat, I wanna feel the pressure way more. So I can't be flat on my back. So he come here to touch the knee on my belly, look, stretch my leg and turn to the side, right? So he can be 500 pounds, he don't wanna bug me here with his weight because I protect my body in a strong position here that his pressure doesn't affect me anymore, right? That's it. So now look, I stop the pressure, number one. Now, how do I wanna get out from here? Right? So, his knee on the belly, this is another big mistake people do. I'm just gonna show for you. One of the main attacks the guy on the top gonna try against me, you know, against me there, is to put this hand deep on my collar, right? And use the other one to try to choke me. I just wanna show, if he, the knee is on the belly, is a very bad attack for him, because if I move my hip, he's gonna fly, he's gonna look the position. I'm gonna block the elbows, right? Right here, if I move my hip now, look, he likes this position. And from here, I control, I just arch back to break the grip, because if I don't break, if I go closer to him, he still can choke me here from the bar, right? So I cannot let the pressure be on my neck. So go back there. So this is a big mistake many people do. They try to choke people with the other bag. If you have a posture, deep in the collar, if you want to attack my neck, first thing you have to do, put this knee on the floor, close to my armpit, drag my head to him, and now with the other hand, he's gonna turn my face with his elbow and hold my shoulder. Yes, okay? So now look, I can't turn, I can't block here. If he's prone now, put all the weight on my neck, I tap here right away. He got power and he destroy my defense here, right? Totally. So what I have to do, I cannot let him do all the steps, right? So, all the steps, I don't like people behind me, please. I'm a Jiu-Jitsu fighter, I don't turn my back for people. Please stay in front of me, yes. Right? So, I don't wanna let you do all the steps to attack me something, I'm lock or choke or whatever, right? So, what you're gonna do, he come back here, he put the knee on the belly. We're gonna do the classic knee on the belly, okay? So he put his hand on the collar, control my arm here, and keep the weight here. But when I throw my body to the side, he cannot apply the same pressure here, right? So this arm, he's controlling here, but this hand is free. So that's the first one I'm gonna try to work. I'm gonna go and hold his belt. Four fingers inside of the belt, like eagle grip, right? So I control right here, and this hand here, he's holding me here. I can't move, he has better leverage than me. I'm gonna circle around and hold his arm too. So now I can fight to pull down, he pull up, I pull down, I'm strong here. Now take a look what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna move my hip now close to him. I move my foot, see? Forward from the back here, right? I move forward. When I shift my hip, look, he likes the position. And I have the control if he tries to come back to the back. Look, I don't like him now. And I can go now, very easy. come to the mat with it. So if you guys want, can try this technique now. Zeke can go one time with Dana. Let's check the camera, man.
Let's. Someone said, did you invent the Corona choke? Derek.
I can prepare for the next class. I need a few minutes to find out.
Someone wants you to demonstrate the triangle.
And Brian before asked a sliding pass, knee on belly sliding pass to mount. Is that right, Brian?
He just did it, right?
No. From near the belly to the mount.
Isn't that what you just did?
No. This one. If you can move it here, please. Put your head this way. These special people ask a lot.
Knee side pass, yeah.
If you are inside the mount, why you go to the mount? Because this guy here on the bottom always gonna keep flexing his leg to block my leg too. If I throw my leg, he block here, right? So put your legs on the ground.
Turn into
on the ground. Put your legs on the ground.
What?
Okay. If his legs on the ground, look, I just do this and I go to the mount. I have nothing blocking me here. But that's not the reality of the fight. The guy on the bottom always gonna flex this leg. When I try, look, his leg is on the way. I can't put my leg there. Right? So I believe that's the question you wanna know. Right? So I am inside the mount position here. And I wanna go to the mount. But I don't want him, right, to block my leg. So what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna control his arm here to distract him. I push the head here, he don't feel comfortable here. And now I go and put my knee on the stomach. See? So from here now I have the arm. I just gonna pull the arm, drop, and I'm right there. This control of the arm here, in my opinion, is very good because stop the guy to try escape right away. I don't give the freedom, right? Mm-hmm. So for him to do the elbow escape here, I keep his arm up. It's not easy for him, right?
Wait. Sorry, guys.
If I control this arm, it's not easy for him to try to escape now. And I put his arm in a bad situation because if I want to attack, the bit lock, so my students know what I'm talking about, is easy to control here, right? So it's gonna be very hard for him to defend the move now. It's totally different, I left the arm here and try to attack. He has the mobility to move the arm and fight back. If I had the control
right here, see, you don't have the same mobility to defend. So now, for example, I just go to the wrist, push it down, and move my leg back, my knee back. Now, very important, I put all my weight on his face. See? This hand come under, the leg's right there. If I don't put my weight on the face, you're gonna bridge, you're gonna push, I don't wanna be successful to do the lock. So, in my opinion, the control of the arm, the elbow, right, to do pitch lock, straight arm lock, whatever, help me to do the move, okay? So, I think so that was the question he would like to know. Let's go move to another one.
Somebody asked, Tom said, can you show a no hands open guard pass from standing, please and thanks.
So, no hands open guard pass.
I don't know if it's a joke.
It's a joke.
I think that must be a joke, so let's go on to something else. Now that I figured I can scroll. Let's see. There was somebody else. I think that was...
I think like a Brian asked a question.
Somebody asked, is this video going to remain on Facebook page to watch again? We're going to try to figure that out. Okay, that was Brian. So I don't think there's been any other...
Guys, I'm white belt in technology, right? So I don't know how to keep the video there, but I want to... ask them to ask for the students, if somebody know how to do, of course they're going to keep the techniques for you guys, check again and practice again.
Okay, so the Tom guy said basically passing the guard, and Orzura, the kids would like to know how to do a Kimura.
From what position, Orzura? From what? The guard, from the top?
She's not, she probably doesn't know. Just show it from the guard.
Okay, so I'm gonna show something basic here from the guard position.
Azor is in the kids class with Eden.
Okay, I'm gonna do it.
I need to find my glasses.
So look, I'm on my way. People do the kimura, right? Because if I don't move my hip, you see my legs are closed, I don't have the mobility to go wrap his arm to attack the kimura, right? So what people do? Open the legs, skip the hip to the opposite side they're going to attack the arm, right? Use this elbow here as a leverage to help to come up and wrap the arm and hold the kimura. But in this position, I cannot stop him. For example, he can put the left, his left foot on the ground and block right here, right? Go back. Another one, when I came here to attack, he can sprawl and keep all the weight of his body on my leg here. Sprawl, yeah, you see? Now look, I have to come back to my hip this way because I can't do the kimura here because all my weight's on my elbow. I can't do it. See, I can't stop him to sprawl and do the lock. Go back. So you see, this situation here, right? So I control the arm. So when I skip my hip here to go and attack, he has defenses to use against me. So I myself, I don't like to go there to catch the arm. So what I'm gonna do, I control the collar, control the sleeve. Look at my move here. When I skip my hip now, right here, I punch his arm. and this hand here on the collar, go and bring the elbow closer to me. Because what happened here? I give no opportunity for him to hold his leg or try to sprawl to the fence. He cannot control my hip movements anymore. Now I just wrap, right? Hold my wrist and the lock is on right away. Okay? We worked some details before about the kimura, right? So take a look here. This is just for you guys to understand that, especially when you do the kimura from the north-south position, right? I believe it is way stronger for the person applying the lock when he controls the arm, right? So let's go suppose, I put the arm here to do it. I put his elbow on my armpit and lock. You see? The power of my kimura is way bigger. And even the guys very flexible on the shoulder, they're gonna lose the flexibility here. See? Trapping the elbow under. And the second little detail to make the opponent less flexible, when I do the kimura, instead of to hold the top of the wrist, I hold the back of the wrist and I twist his arm. Because when I do that, see, he likes, he's stepping before I even lock. I totally destroy his resistance against the move, right? So his flexibility is going now with just a little twist of the wrist. I just put the elbow, same line of the shoulder. Look, I'm gonna tap. But when you guys lock, if you put the elbow on your armpit and you hold it right here, it's very strong position. So please try that in next class. You guys can tell what you guys think about these little things. Okay?
Do we have time for one more question, or
yes,
do we want to?
Okay.
So somebody said that's what he actually wanted to see. This guy is still saying about the guard pass, a guard pass without using any grips to pass the guard, just your feet, an open guard.
Maybe the drill where you go to the side and put the knee on the belly.
Do you know what he's talking about?
Take a look. About this question, if I don't use my hands to control the leg of the guy, I'm never gonna pass the guard because his hip is gonna have freedom to move and he keep crossing the leg, putting his feet on my hip to push him away, putting the hooks. So I have to kill the legs to pass the guard. Without arms, I'm sorry, but one guy, armless, I think so is very hard to pass someone's guard. Even if you have the two arms, it's not easy. Sometimes the guy is very flexible, you know? So, I'm telling the truth here. If you don't use your hands to pass the guard, one guy has one okay guard, not even a very good guard. My friend, you can try, you know, until Christmas, and you still don't want to pass his guard. This is the reality. So, maybe you want to know something else, but I'm sorry, I didn't understand your question.
Okay, well, do Mark Mullen has a question here from Toronto.
Tarado. Alzeja Tarado.
He said, original student in 1998, I would like to see the details of the Taraida or bullfighter?
I'm sorry? What's it say?
Oh, toreada.
Oh. Sorry.
Sorry, my help here. I have no clue Portuguese.
No.
So, this is a guy who passed that you call bull riding, like if you have the I'm sure you have this in your appointments, in your book, with all the details that I showed in 1997 for you. So, 23 years ago. So, take a look here. To do this guarded pass here, it's very important you don't expose your arms, right? So some people just wanna dominate the knees here, right? Create space to pin the legs on the ground to pass. But this is wrong because put your feet on the ground and sit. If the person sits, look at my elbows right here. He swim under my elbow here, cup my elbow. Look, he attacked my arm. I'm gonna put foot on the hip now. Boom, my arm is done. So I cannot expose my, I can be like a couple like this, the guy attacking my arms here, right? So the position to do this guarded pass, very important. You keep one palm facing the opponent, one palm facing you, right? But how I said, right? I have the grips right here, right? And I stand up to pass. So what I'm gonna do here, this hand here facing him is the one I'm gonna work. I'm gonna lift his legs from the ground to make it hard him to sit. If I try to sit here, he can't sit, right? If I like to put his feet on the ground, move back a little bit, you can see it very easy, and attack, right? So that's what I'm saying. When I do the grip here, I'm gonna take his feet off the ground. Now, the same side, my hand is facing his face, I'm gonna step back and pin his leg on the ground, you see it? He cannot come to attack this elbow here because I put all the pressure here. He has no condition. Now I step double foot back and push together and I come. You see? So now I'm right there, side mount, and I gave no opportunity to the opponent attack my arm. I hope you enjoy, my friends.
Okay, let me see if there's any other. Nathan, if someone is in a strong turtle, how does Marcus like to open the turtle and transition to a submission? So if they're...
Okay.
Yeah, be tight.
Yeah, protect your neck and hide your elbows. See? So some people go like this. Keep your elbows against your belly, see? Sometimes, take a look here. Even if I lift the person, I hold the belt on the collar, he still, no, keep your knees on your chest. Yeah, look, he still don't give me space to put the hooks. So some people, they hide everything, don't give it to you, right? So, if they touch, they block everything, don't give you space, right? One of the techniques I like to use is I wanna push him to the side a little bit here, right? And push my knee over his ankle, my knee on the ground, go right here, and I pin his ankle on the ground. Take a look how he opened everything for me. It's very comfortable here, right? You can also stand up and you step on the ankle. Look, you open. It's like the magic word, open to seven. Boom, everything's open. So these ankle touches here are very effective, in my opinion, right? And the other one, so I believe some tournaments not illegal to do, but in real fights, You know, it's not a dirty move, it's just some pressure. I can keep the grip here on the belt and the collar, stand up, and put my rotula, my bone of my knee, in on his back. Then I pull here, look, it's gonna open too. So I have room to come to the neck, right? So the pressure always gonna open space for you, right? But let's go see something else. He hides everything again, right? So, it's hard to find something, okay? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna hold the collar right here to keep it pulling. And this hand here, I'm gonna hold his, the end of the pants. See, four fingers inside, make the grip. Now, my elbow go to his rib right here. Look, it's a lot of pressure on the rib. They turn it to me and they give me the neck again, right? So now I slide my hands, hold the collar, dip, and I'm ready to attack. If I sit him now, I move it back. You have no condition to run away or defend this. Just so you see, I have the control. His both hands are free, right? But you see how my hip push him? And I pull right here. So before he try to do anything here, the choke gonna come. He can try to use both hands to defend here. But look, see. So this contrast with pegs here, very important.
Nathan says sorry, Zeke. Okay, so it's maybe wrap up time. Walter had one question for that last pass you just did, was why did you switch the knee, the grips on the kneecap or something? Why are the hands switched?
I switched the grip exactly, I don't expose my elbow. Be like this, mm-hmm. Right? Guys, take a look here. Stand up here. Hold my knees. Boom, boom. Usually look, his palm is facing him, right? So if the guy, I'm fighting here, the guy came, boom, hold my knees, right? Look what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna push him, sit, and try to keep my legs open. Because if I close here, he push my knee down like around and pass. So I make it easy to the guy to do that, right? So every time he hold my knees, I'm gonna push him, sit, and open my legs. This end here, I go to the collar and put my knuckles on his collarbone. It's super painful. If you try to walk to me to pass, look how I push him in relaxing the grip. Mm-hmm. Right? Or I can go, let go here and catch the line. Also, so that's the reason. If his switch, right, he step this leg back, pee my knee on the ground, look, I even have no balance to attack this arm here, and he's always protected here. It's totally different. Hold on, you see, then like that. Because like that, I can cup and I attack right away. The other way, look, I can't cut there. I'm going to go inside. Now I put all the weight here, step the other one back, push this one to the top, boom, and walk around and pass. So that's the reason. It's like when you do deadlift, opposite grips. And another one.
I think that's it for today. Walter said thank you. And
so, okay guys. So today was the first day We are still white belts to do these techniques on video. I still not very comfortable to talk to videos, you know, the first time I'm doing this. But I hope that tomorrow we can be a little better. And tomorrow at the same time, we're gonna be recording the techniques from the Langley gym. And Wednesday I come back to Vancouver. Thursday I'm gonna be back in the Langley gym. And Friday I'm gonna be in the Maple Ridge gym. Okay? So thank you very much. I miss you guys a lot. I hope we can be together so I can give a real hug to everybody. And don't forget, we always try to help everybody we can, right? So, how everybody know, one of our black belts, Benito, passed away. So we did some t-shirts,
sure.
Okay? To send all the profit to his daughter, that's the single mom, and we're gonna try to do our best to support him, because I can guarantee if this happened to me, he would be doing the same, right? So the shirt's very nice. Anybody interested, right? We're gonna be 6 o'clock at the locations that I told you. Monday, Wednesday, Vancouver, Tuesday and Thursday, Langley, and Friday in Maple Ridge. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And I hope we can be together soon.
Gosh.